Hi, T-Star Galacticans and little Vixies alike. It's like the old days where I would talk at you in my robe with no makeup on, just woke up out of bed. Those times are back, and I feel like crap. And I like every time I talk, I feel like I might vomit. But I don't think I'm sick. It's really a weird scenario. It's strange, and of course, you know, Stinky's here as well. I should just say, hi, little Vixies. It's me, Lady Vixen, and Stinky, nibbling at my feet. Again. I know, it just never changes. It's just the same... Okay, false alarm. I'm okay. No vomiting. Alright, so I'm just gonna go into today's damn question so I don't risk, you know, hurling on camera. Well, that might be good video making. I don't know. First, actually, what I do want to mention and talk about for just one moment, because this video is about enhancing your life, I find it hard to talk about when so many people in Japan... are not, you know, just everything that's been happening. And stop nibbling my damn feet. I don't know, I'm just like thinking about it, you know, kind of puts me into a little bit of a bad mood. And even though it just seems like there's a natural disaster, I've just kicked my cat. Just kidding. Get away from me. Leave. You're annoying me. Biting my feet. I don't like that shit. Sorry. Hi. No, but I mean, I just wanted to... I couldn't make this video without, you know, mentioning it, and I know that everybody has probably mentioned it in their videos, and... it's just really horrible. And... I really get affected by, like, major world tragedies, as not everyone does. I mean, I do, though. Everyone tends to, like, really affect me. And something locally can happen, and I'm just kind of like, eh. But when it's, like, these major... In a lot of ways, you know, Japan's screwed. And... It really hurts to see that, and really makes you think about, even if you are not feeling well, and you feel like you're going to vomit, and your cat's nibbling your toes, and you still are waking up, and things are safe, and things are okay, and it's spring, and, you know, I woke up next to my fiancé, and we're all alive, you know what I mean? At the end of the day, like, that's really all that fucking matters. And when these things happen, it's just, like, the devastation. And it's just, they couldn't imagine it. But I try to, because it keeps me in check. It keeps my life in check. It keeps me really grateful and thankful for missing it this time, you know? And I just couldn't imagine what it would be like to have to endure something like that. So, wow, that was not intentional. By the way, my computer, it's probably going to happen again. It just dims and... So anyway, I just wanted to, like, at least mention that, because I think it's very important, and my thoughts and prayers are with Diana. I know that she is... It wasn't near the epicenter, but I know that they're also... You know, because of the nuclear reactors failing and everything else, and partial meltdowns, that even in Tokyo they're feeling a much higher rate of radioactive activity levels. So I know that she's more in mid-southern Japan, but I just, you know, my thoughts and prayers are with you, because I know that you probably did know people all around the country. So anyway, today is, the question is, I'm already at 5 minutes, I apologize. How has your transition enriched your life? That's an easy question. I mean, a hard question, actually, because it's enriched my life in so many ways. It's made me definitely a stronger person. You know, I know that I can survive without many things because it tends to, in transition, you know, things, I mean people, there is some fallout no matter what, and it's okay, it's part of life, and it's definitely part of transition, and if you made it through transition without any fallout, you were extremely lucky, you know. But I know that I can make, for instance, I can make it through without my father. He's kind of shown me that he doesn't want much to do with me. Not in a mean way or a condemning way, just a very kind of passive way. You know, not inviting me to things, not, you know, like sending me my mail, like all the mail that, you know, would go to their house that was just like residual mail he used to use as a way to get me over to his house so I would see him. Pick up your mail, pick up your mail. And now he's sending my mail to me with my old name on every letter, like he wrote my name on it. So, and he doesn't call me, and you know, just like things. So I've learned that I can live without my father, and I can live without his help financially. And that's so been a huge thing in my life, to have financial independence and to know that you can make it. And is so awesome, you know. Aside from that, just my regular demeanor is better. I feel like I'm a little bit more in control of my feelings, or if I am not feeling well, instead of being scared of it because I have to go to work today, and if I don't feel good, like, I have to work today, and I feel like ass, you know, before I would freak out and be like, well, what are, you know, what's gonna happen, and now, like, and it's just because of estrogen, to be honest with you, I don't give a flying fuck, you know, I mean, I don't feel good, and I'm basically what that means is that I'm more stable in who I am at any given time. I guess that's the answer to the question. I'm more stable with who I am at any given time. You know, aside from before having like a panic attack all the time about everything. You know, when I had a lot of testosterone coursing through my body and unchecked gender dysphoria. So now, yeah. So that's my answer. I'm stable, or whatever I just said. I don't even remember what I just said now. I don't really care. All right, so let's see the second part of the question here. Oh, and this question is by Courtney, by the way, so thank you, Courtney. Anyway, bonus question is, what is your preferred choice of underwear and why? Well, I really do like, and this has been more recent, but as my butt has gotten bigger, I used to just be able to wear regular panties, and I hate that word, but, you know, regular women's underwear, there we go, that's better. And what I would do is I would just kind of, like, if I was wearing jeans, because I don't like the panty line look, I would just kind of, like, stuff the panties in my butt crack, and I know that's a little bit TMI, but it used to work, because I didn't have a butt as much. And now that my butt is just, like, you know, I got a little bit of a badonkadonk, I'm liking thongs a little bit better, but I can only wear thongs after my testicles shrank to a certain level, or, you know, what would happen. It would have been, you know, pretty horrid, actually. But after being on estrogen, I don't know if I have testicles anymore, so it's all just kind of flat down there. I know, TMI, again, that's why you came to this channel. It's all trans stuff, so. So I do like thongs, actually, and I never thought I would. I never, ever thought I would, and I'm not, like, the thong kind of girl, like, you know, my mentality, but I do enjoy them. And boxers. I am starting to enjoy boxers. And I never enjoyed them as a male, But now, I think it's like the hottest thing ever for a girl to wear boxers. And a white beater. I'll call it a white because I'm not going into the wife beating right now. No. Yeah. So, I wear my... And wearing your fiancé's boxers and, you know, white tank top. There we go. That's neutral. It's just so hot. I love it. I love it. And he wears... I love men in boxer briefs, tube socks, and a white tank top. That's the way I like my man. And come on, you can't... I don't know what it is, but if a trans man does that... Holy shit! I don't know what it is, but it's like the hottest thing ever. I don't know. I wonder... You know, I think I'm gonna go have sex with him right now, actually. Alright. That was just my segue to end the video, actually. I probably won't. Maybe I will. I don't know. But anyway, I'm sorry for this ridiculous video. It was stupid. I'm tired, bitchy, cranky, mid-cycle-ish. Yeah. Alright. Enjoy the spring as much as you can. Be thankful for what you have. And... really think about what's going on in the mass devastation to another region of the world as much as you can, and then come back to your own reality and just live, keep on keeping on. That's all we can do. Alright, I love you all. Mwah. And I will see you next week with a more chipper video, hopefully. Maybe not, because I'm cool with whatever way I am.